RSS was formed in 1925 and with the sole purpose of building a Hindu Rashtra. In 1925, they were very clear. Golwalkar, when he's writing in a bunch of thoughts and other books, he's very clear that he wants to build a nation where minorities are second class citizens. And he quotes Hitler, he quotes from how the Nazi Germany and how in Italy Mussolini and others have worked on this, and how they have managed to keep in Germany, managed to keep the Jews, and how they have shown the world that Jews do not deserve to be even alive. So they draw inspirations from Germany and Italy, and you know, fascism and Nazism from there, and they want to build that nation. Unfortunately for them, at that point, the progressive forces, the whole movement to defeat the British, the independence movement is very, very strong. And it becomes very strong as, you know, the time passes, and with Gandhi and Nehru and Sardar Patel and many other, Bhagat Singh, many other leaders. There is and participation of huge number of ordinary Indians. The national movement becomes a movement for not only for building a nation and defeating the British and throwing them out, but also building a nation which is based on equality and justice. And those are the values which the national movement carries itself, where there is no space for RSS and its thinking. So it remains on the periphery. Then in 48, they kill Mahatma Gandhi. And after that, RSS is banned by Sardar Patel, who was the Home Minister at that time. But that doesn't stop RSS from functioning. After a few years, it was revoked. When we attained independence, whether it was Nehru or other leaders, they were all busy in building the nation. The literacy at that time was 23%, female literacy. There were no colleges, there was no institutions. I mean, this has become a fashion to say, what have we got in 70 years? So every single, your universities, your science institutions, your IITs, your IIMs, and all these CSIR and the laboratories and all the major science institutes and the kind of research which is going on, which is at the national level. You know, ISRO, everything was built after we got independence. So the whole administration, the leadership, they were busy in building a new India. An India which believed in equality, where poverty had to be fought, where discrimination had to be fought, and people needed to be taken forward. And we achieved a lot of things. It is not that India did not achieve anything. Even if I go back in my childhood and now, the living standards of Indians have grown up, especially the middle classes. They have gone up many, many folds from where we had started. Yes, there are many problems, and now, especially in the last 3-4 years, the kind of poverty that we are seeing and the discrimination between those who have and those who don't, it's a big gap now. But what the leaders did not do or think, that these forces which wanted to build the Hindu Rashtra, they are very much alive. There was Muslim League which said Muslims are a different nation, the two nation theory. Two nation theory was first propagated by Savarkar, and not by, where he talks about Hindus being a nation. So while the Muslim League goes away with the Pakistan and Jinnah and everyone is there, but those who did not want a democratic secular nation, they remained here, and they kept working on this ideology and the ideology of hatred against all others, except the upper caste. It's a very Brahmanical kind of, you know, thinking, where only space is available for the upper caste in the so-called Hindu Rashtra. Dalits are outcast, and Muslims and Christians, of course, are outcast. And Adivasi and even women, there is no space. So while on one hand we are building the nation, on the other hand these forces started working. They are not visible to people. In late 60s, they targeted the tribal beds, where they started these Ekal Vidyalayas. And then they sent one sadhu each to each of the tribal belts, to Dang, to Savarkantha, to Kandamal, to Alirajpur, to Jabua in Madhya Pradesh, all the major tribal belts in Odisha and everywhere. They sent just one sadhu who would roam around and sing bhajans, and over a period of 10 years, 20 years, then build all these groups which would then start the hatred campaign against the Christians. In tribal belts, it is not so much against the Muslims, because in those remote areas, only Christian missionaries had gone. Then they were providing education and medical facilities. Also, the RSS became very perturbed because it didn't believe in Adivasis getting anywhere. With Christian missionaries going there and Adivasis getting education and reaching through also affirmative actions of the government of India at that time, where reservation is there, reaching certain positions which were against the ideology of RSS. So even from that point of view, they had to attack these groups. And so we see that in 60s and 70s tribal belts, at the same time, I remember in New Delhi, all these Bhagavati Jagrans, very small, which start in the middle class colleges, where somebody is coming and doing Bhagavati Jagran. And then slowly then the Ayodhya movement starts. With the Ayodhya movement and around that, just before that, you have a full-fledged intervention in the television. And all televisions are only playing Ramayana. So it is attacking the mind from all sides. So then the New Age Guru appear, and their work is only one thing, that they have to mobilize big number of people, masses, who would start believing in one person and who would not think rationally. So whatever the guru is saying is right. And it is, if you see that through the 80s and 90s, you see huge gatherings behind, whether it is Asaram Bapu or it is somebody else, or the two of them are now in jail, or even Ravi Shankar or Anandmayi Mata, and all kinds of men and women who suddenly appear and they become huge gurus, spiritual gurus. They are kind of preparing large masses to just not think, not rationalize, but follow. And after this whole process, only after this whole process is done, Modi appears on the scene, where already the minds are controlled, hatred is inside the minds, because over 20 years, 30 years, you have propagated hatred against Muslims, against Christians, against Adivasis and women and so forth. Then after that, Modi appears, he talks of development and everything, and people are already accustomed to just follow, like a big herd. And this herd, which now we call bucks, it just follows, and follows that dream which is not there. But it is already, I'm telling you in just 5 minutes, but it's a process which has happened over decades of controlling the minds, of poisoning the mind, like it was happening in Germany. In Germany it was happening against the Jews. In India it has happened against the Muslims and the Christians and Adivasis and that is. And then during this period also they have controlled education. They run more than a few years ago, almost 10 years ago, they used to run over 60,000 Shishu Mandis. Through these Shishu Mandis, they are teaching people hatred. Then they are running the Shakhas. So it is not one level. It is multiple levels. They have controlled the media. They have controlled what kind of serials would come. In 70s, you had serials where you would see a woman who is a lawyer, people are looking up to it. Then you suddenly find yourself in the middle of Sasbi Kavi Bahuti. Any woman who wants to build a career is shown as a characterless woman. Only a woman who believes in the values of a joint family and who, looks after her sasuji, and only that woman is acceptable. So it is not one thing where they are attacking. They are attacking at every level, at everything which is progressive, which talks of liberalism or an open mindset, everywhere they are attacking. And then, meanwhile, of course, 2002 happens and so many other riots happen. Everything is used to polarize the minds. In the last two decades, they also used terror in a big way. It was only in 2006 that in Nanded, bombs were exploded. And it was found that they were being made inside the house of an RSS pracharak. That is when people realize that RSS is making bombs. They are making bombs, they are exploding them, and they are saying Muslim boys are terrorists. And one after another, Sanatan Sansthan, and so many of them, these things came out that in most of these bomb blasts, not all, but most of them, RSS was involved. And Karkare, Hemant Karkare. Hemant Karkare starts investigating and he reaches the bottom of this and he connects all the dots. And then this Bombay happens and he's dead. So, you know, I ask questions about that also. Was he killed by terrorist? Was he bumped off? I mean, there are all these questions because they tried everything to convince Karkare to change what was there in the files. And he refused. He refused. His family, his father was a neighbor of one of the RSS persons. So through that, because they were neighbors at some point, they tried to pressurize Karkare to, you know, to not put RSS and all the terror details. Because he refused to do that, whatever happened, I can't say for sure, but there are question marks around his death also. And there are many people who have questioned his death, the way he was shot dead and the way he died. So the whole terror network is used to malign against the Muslims. If you look at today, triple talaq is being used. We have fought against triple talaq. All women organizations have fought against instant triple talaq. Not against triple talaq, but instant triple talaq. And once the Supreme Court bans it, it's over. The question is over. Because even if somebody says talaq, 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 it's invalid. But now, only to polarize, they are bringing this new bill where they are saying we will put send the man to the jail. If you want to send every man to the jail who is abandoning his wife, then let's begin with Mr. Modi. He abandoned his wife. Why only the Muslim man? Why are you only concerned about the Muslim woman? What about the Hindu woman? Every single day there are 2-3 dowry deaths and there are so many abandonments. And the bigamy is a lot more among the Hindus statistically than it is among the Muslims. So then let's start sending everyone to jail. So it's a political project to just, you know, segregate and keep on polarizing the people. Also because, see, according to the latest survey, 1% of the topmost people in India have 73% of nation's wealth. And these topmost people are Adani and Ambani and the likes. People who fund Mr. Modi's elections. And there would be others. Now, if you want to ensure that the lower rung, which is whatever, 70-80% of the people, don't question what happened in demonetization? Where are the 2 crore jobs? Why only 1% people have 73% of India's wealth? What about us? Why are farmers committing suicide? What's happening to students? Why are the scholarships are banned? Why is the government cutting the budget on education and science and women ministries? You don't ask these questions. So you have to be busy in cow-vigilantism, in Romeo, in love jihad, in attacking, or in Pakistan is attacking us on our borders, and so on and so forth. So they'll keep on creating issues so that people of this country do not ask the real questions. And right now we are in a situation where these forces have become so powerful. They have entered almost every space, whether public or private, they have entered everything. In India, if 4 topmost judges had to come and do a press conference, which is unprecedented in our history, then people need to think what is happening. You know, our democratic structures are being subverted. And this government cares a damn about parliament, about ethics, about democracy, about secularism, about the constitution. So the only way to defeat them is to, one, that there has to be a people's movement, and secondly, all democratic secular parties have to come together and form a coalition. There cannot be any ifs and buts in there. Because if you understand that fascism is knocking at our doors and we need to defeat them, then this party is good and that party is bad. You have to rise above that. Because the first and foremost thing is to defeat them. And for that, a coalition is required.